Dear ladies and gentlemen, dear distinguished participants, dear Claude, dear Carlo, this is the seventh consecutive time that I have the honor to speak at the Luxembourg Internet Days. It never was a routine. Each edition was unique, but this year it is a special edition. A special edition in many ways. Six times I was able to wish you a warm welcome to Luxembourg. The Luxembourg Internet Days managed to attract a growing number of attendants over the past years, reaching over thousands of participants. This time, I wish you a warm welcome from Luxembourg. The COVID-19 pandemic forces us to respect precautionary measures. But this didn't stop the organizers and attendants to join virtually today. I would like to congratulate the organizers, the LUCX management, the LUCX office team, and the advisory board for what they have prepared this year. A fully web-based Luxembourg Internet Days that promises to be much more than a compromise given the actual circumstances. The previous editions always gave me a great overview on how vibrant and diverse the Internet community has got. I was able to shake hands with actors from Luxembourg and the greater region. Now that we are gathering in this online edition, I'm happy to hear that the Luxembourg Internet Days got even more international, both in terms of speakers and attendance. And we shall not take this for granted. If there is one thing that we experienced in the first months of the COVID breakout in Europe, it was that we shall never take the international connections and the international collaboration for granted. Many closed national borders again, thinking that it would contain the outbreak of a virus. As a small country, we believe in international solidarity and international collaboration to get through the crisis as unharmed as possible. I'm aware that today I'm addressing you, a very skilled and dedicated ICT community with a great expertise in security incidents. So it would be unrespectful to say that containment would not be one of the viable options to pick while facing an outbreak of a virus. But like for the internet, national borders do not present an actual barrier or criteria to handle the virus. Solutions are to be much more reflected and effective. When in March 2020, I was sitting down with my government and was presented the options at stake, we had to take very difficult decisions affecting our everyday life. The decision to ask schools, offices and industries alike to switch to online mode. This lockdown helped us to slow down the outbreak of COVID-19 at this most lethal moment so far. We could take this decision because we knew that we had invested intensively over the past decades in both our national and international connectivity. We knew that we invested in our server capacity and our telecommunication equipment. And we knew that you had grown into a very talented, experienced and devoted ICT community. My teams were monitoring together with you the state of the network during the lockdown. As Claude correctly stated, our telecommunication network certainly was challenged, but not struggling. And I'm proud to see that you did not sit back and did not wait for the peak traffic to pass in order to return to business as usual. Some of you have invested into additional redundancy. Others adapted the traffic load and server capacities. Some of you started to develop solutions for your customers. While many private and public bodies were prepared for a strict home office, some others were adapting themselves within a very short time. Let me therefore thank you all for your professionalism and your dedication. You proved to be a true backbone, a backbone for our economy, yes. But let's not forget that you're also the backbone of our online schooling, for our digital communities, and ultimately for our modern everyday life. Thank you for that. It is in the moments of social isolation that we cherish the digital communication tools that we have at hand. And it is thanks to you, organizers and participants of this event, that we can keep close by having reliable phone calls, by sharing our life through personal pictures, family videos or via video calls. It is a special edition this year because during previous editions, the Luxembourg Internet Days mainly gave us a look ahead. Like at many conferences, speakers tended to present their visions, companies presented their business plans. It also has been at many occasions a perfect platform to present or to launch the latest initiatives from my government or my administrations. Having a look at the program of the Luxembourg Internet Days, appreciate the fact that you will use the opportunity to take a step back to reflect on what has been done so far in order to draw the appropriate conclusions for the months and years to come. This will make us ready for future challenges, some of which are already in our sight, and thus part of the program of this year. Let me just pick the effect of quantum technologies on future internet security challenges, or the security challenges that are associated with the cloud. This year's edition not only hosts a digital conference, but it also gave birth to digital networking. I thank LUCIX for the efforts that they have invested to offer you a truly enriching event. You can wander around the digital equivalent of the exhibition area we all benefited from. You will also be able to dive deeper in specific sidetracks and workshops. From my point of view, the digital networking is especially important in times of social distancing. In particular, I invite you all to use the digital alternatives to the coffee breaks. I wish you many successful networking chats. They are an important part of any conference or seminar. Let me extend my regards also to the IT and media specialists behind the servers and keyboards that managed to combine necessary hardware and software to create something new, something unique for today and the 2 days to come. Last but not least, it is a special edition because it was a first to have Claude Demuth introduce the Luxembourg Internet Days. I would like to use the opportunity to thank Marco Hohen for all the dedication he has invested in shaping these events and in sitting up and leading the Luxembourg Internet Node. I wish him all the best for the new projects that he has started and that he still has in mind. I would also like to thank both Claude and Marco for the perfect transition that you have mastered so far and wish Claude and his team all the best to future develop the legacy that Marco has established. All goodness. But I would like to conclude by wishing you a very pleasant and successful participation at the first web edition of the Luxembourg Internet Days. I hope that you will appreciate this event and that especially if it's your first digital step into Luxembourg, it will motivate you to come to Luxembourg next time. I'm looking forward to welcome you in person at next year's edition.